Hello gardeners, and welcome to another tutorial on transplanting. Today we're going to be transplanting tomato plants. We have them in the peat pellets, as you can see here, and I'm going to be transplanting them into a bigger pot, or a pot, like this here. With the soil mixture that I have the Jiffy's peat. It's an organic. Usually I have the bag right with me, but I just threw it out because I just mixed up a batch. It's a natural organic type peat. Also, I have worm castings that I've made here. Also, some compost from last year. So let's get started. Okay, so I've got quite a few. I know I've got two of the Roma, I think it's VF. I know it's a organic seed. It's also an heirloom, which I'm excited. Almost everything that I'm growing this year is going to be heirloom, so I can collect the seeds and use them again next year. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this pot, put some soil in it. Actually, let me put this down a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so I'm going to take this plant. I got to keep these separated because I got two different types here. I'm going to put it in there. Now, unlike the peppers that we did, I don't mind if the stem gets buried some. In fact, on this particular plant, I'm not sure why she's just so droopy, but I don't care if the soil goes up around that stem. When you plant it in the garden, it's going to be up around the stem. I'm just going to fill up around it, pack it down. You don't have to pack it down real tight, but gently. Like with the peppers, within a couple, 3 days, boy, I'll tell you what, you're going to see a big difference on these plants. Okay, so there's one. That's that Roma. That, and once these get into the light, that will make a big difference with them too. That one down like so. Poke around that. I don't want air pockets down there. That's it. I'm not pushing down hard. I'm just, somebody might say, boy, you're being mean to that plant. They're tough. They can do it. They can handle it. I've got some water in the bottom of the tray, so that's going to help soak up, moisten that soil, but I'll also water that after. So put a little soil in there. This one's a little leggy. But you can see even the roots are starting to come out. So that's good. They're healthy. I like healthy plants. Ideally, I would have liked to have gone with a little deeper pot, but I can see right now I'm going to run out of room in that seed rack behind me. You know, by the time you take them out of these little pots here, or the seed pellets, you put them into a bigger pot, that takes up quite a bit of room in the seed rack. I found that with the peppers. And it's going to be a while before these babies can get outside. My garden still has about 3 feet in almost all of it. Some places more. We have been down below zero. In fact, over the weekend, wind chills were down 25, 30 below zero. Today is a milder day. Today is Monday, March 13th. It's a milder day, but we have got a huge snowstorm coming. Now, I'm hoping it's going to stay off to the east, stay out in the Atlantic Ocean, but they're talking somewhere near 2 feet in a 24-hour span. So, gotta love living in Maine. My wife's real excited. My wife is not one that likes the cold. Doesn't like the cold. Not crazy about the snow. Yeah, it's pretty, but she knows it comes with the cold. So. And I think the only reason she's living here in Maine is because this is where I am. This is where I pretty much grew up. I love it. I love the people. I have been in other parts of the country. I'm not putting your part of the country down, but I love it here. People are just awesome. It's a great place to live. Yes, this place is in Maine where you've got crime and it's like everywhere else. But you know, I've been in other states and again, I'm not saying that there aren't people like this, but when you have somebody in need, it seems like even though we are probably the poorest state in the nation, and the area where we live in is the bounces back and forth between the poorest community to the second poorest community in the state, you see people reach out for others. I just like that. Like I said, I know there's other states. This is the same thing, but to me, that's valuable. You know, to live in a place like that. Almost all my life, I dairy farmed. Other than when I was in service, other than when I drove truck, other than when I had my own DJ service, and some other things. For those who have done much in the agricultural field, you know that we've had a hard time with it. Governments got involved with it, of course. That's been hard. It's been a hard go for a lot of them. What do we got here? We've got an unmarked one. I'm grabbing from the wrong. I'll have to remember that. Those are Amish base. I can make up a new one. I've been following quite a few YouTubers. On YouTube. And a lot of them have really come out with some great tips. Of course, I've been following Justin Rhodes for quite a while and seeing some of the farms that he's visiting. Of course, they've had some fun times too. You know, they've gone to different museums, zoos. If you haven't visited his channel before, I would really suggest that you do. I know he's planning on coming up here in Maine. I don't know where, but I'd really like to meet up with him. I just love that family, you know, and they keep it real. Another one, Daddy Curbs. There's another one. Look at the roots that are coming out of that. That's a good sign. Daddy Curbs, can't remember if it's gardens or homesteads. I really, really enjoy his channel, seeing what he's doing. And again, he's another one. He's real. You know, he'll show in the videos where he makes mistakes. The other day, I was transplanting peppers. And I had some of these tomatoes that I had sitting over there, and I pushed one of the trays too hard, and it went over the table onto the floor. Didn't do anything. Plants were fine. But you know what? I could have stopped the video and just keep it real. Keep it real. You know, I mean, we're all going to goof up. That's what I like about his channel. He's real, you know, and he'll tell you he's no expert. Same as me. I'm not an expert. I'm just showing you the things that work great for me. Last Saturday, he did a live show, and I may do some of that. I'm not sure. But anyways, I met quite a few people that were visiting from all over the place. I think there was somebody from Holland. But anyways, I like that. There's been a few girls that have started following me on, from California, and grabbing that pile again. California, Washington State, you know, and they're kind of excited in some of the stuff that I'm doing. They're doing the same. Of course, they're because of the zone that they live in, they're a lot much more warmer. I mean, their growing season starts a lot earlier than what we do here. You know, I will probably get some of the stuff started out in the garden beginning of May, if the snow's all gone by then. There, so I don't grab those. Where was that going? Oh, another one. Is it Callie Kim? I think that's her channel. She's from California. And I've liked hers. I've liked her videos. I've watched her for quite a few years. I know she does different tips on how she does things. They do a good job. I think it's her husband. I've enjoyed watching. I with this new channel that I have, Jim's in Town Garden. You know, it hasn't been a new hasn't been a channel around very long. And some of them that I've been following for a long time, I don't think they know who I am. You know, because I comment often throughout the years. They usually comment back. I don't get so much of that anymore with this new channel, and that's all right. That's all right. Patrick's channel. It's a long name. One Yard Solutions or whatever, and at some point I'm going to link all these channels that I'm talking about on my channel, because these are great people, and they have great tips. You know, when I get into the back to Eden Garden, when I can get out into the garden, show you how I do that. You know, if L2 Survive will allow me to link his channel. You know, he does interviews with Paul Gauci. And we got one more. You know, this way I can link, and you can meet the one that I learned all this from. You know, he is a Christian man, but he doesn't, even though he does mention God, Creator, if you're not a believer, you know what, there are great videos to watch. I am a Christian. I do teach, but I don't force it on other people. That's a decision that they have to make, and I'll leave it at that. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause this video for a minute, and I'll be back. I'll get them watered, and we'll put them into the seed rack. We'll see you in just a few minutes. I don't know how well you're going to be able to see in there, but there's peppers. A few more of the peppers. I've got one little guy there. I don't know how he's going to do, but anyways. And we come down here, and you can see the tomato plants in there. Couple peppers. Those two peppers I'll be topping here right off quick. And I'll let you see that when I do that. So, I got a wasp up in the corner. He's been hanging around there the last couple days. I had just gone down and checked the heat on this, and you can see I've got my thing that measures the temperature there. This is going to be warmer, and this has been averaging right around 78 degrees. Lower part usually stays somewhere around 75 degrees, so. So, I hope this video might have showed how easy it is to transplant. A lot of those tomato plants are actually the pepper plants that I did a couple days ago. They were pretty young. But I wanted them to get the heat, and where I wanted to leave the rest out of the direct sunlight so that they would germinate, I had to do something. So, anyways, they are growing. They're doing a great job. And I think the ones that I did this morning will also do well. The tomatoes, I think it's hard to kill tomatoes unless you don't get enough water to them. Those I watered, and what I'll probably do is tomorrow give them a little bit more and then just watch them grow. What I'll do is when the plants start hitting the lights, I'll bring it back up, probably about an inch and a half above. And I'll just have to watch them. You know, I might have to raise the lights up every 2 or 3 days. We'll just see how they do. So anyways, I hope this helped. If you like this video, please click the like. Also, subscribe if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet. Share the video. Share the video with your friends. I want everybody to know how easy gardening is. Can't wait to get out into the garden. Like I said, I've got about 2 or 3 feet of snow still in the garden. We've got possibly 2 feet of snow coming Tuesday into Wednesday. Cold, windy. So, again, we thank you. Have a great day.